All right, so here's another caveat in C. So consider this question here. So given the following code, how much space will be allocated for the data variable? Assume that chars are 1 byte each and that ints are 4 bytes each. So we have a struct here that has 3 chars and 1 int. So take a minute and think about how much space do you think will be allocated for this variable. Okay, so clearly the most obvious thing to do here is to simply add up the storage requirements for all of the things that are in it, right? If you're storing 3 chars and an int, then it stands to reason that you're going to need at least, 3 bytes for the 3 characters and then another 4 bytes for the int, so 7 bytes, right? So B is sort of the logical answer here. Unfortunately, if you actually did this on Stew, I think you would find that it's actually going to take up 8 bytes. And if you did it on some other system, it might actually be even more bytes than that. So 7 is kind of the minimum number of bytes. And so the correct answer here is E. There's not enough information to know. And the reason for that is that in C, by default, the compiler is allowed to insert padding into the struct. It may not be immediately clear why this is important right now. We'll return to this later on in the semester to explain why this is important. But basically, it means that if you can insert padding, sometimes you can make it faster to access certain fields. So this is what we call word addressable boundaries. And if that doesn't make any sense right now, that's fine. But for now, we just need to be aware that the compiler can do this. So for instance, like I said earlier, the compiler might choose to insert a byte's worth of padding between the 3 characters and the integer in order that the integer starts on a 4-byte word boundary. So this is fine in most cases, and in general, like I said, this is done to improve the speed, so it's something that we generally want to happen. But there are times in this course where we will want to prevent this from happening. Because we're going to be working at the low level, we're going to be working with structs that have been initialized with data that's been read in from disk, from binary files, and so we want to make sure that the compiler is not inserting padding anywhere. And so in various places in the projects for this course, you're going to see this attribute here, so attribute packed. This is a non-portable and non-standard thing to do here, and this is why I wanted to bring this up so that you can understand what's going on. Basically, we're using something that tells the GCC compiler, which is the one that we're using in this course, tells it not to insert padding. In essence, we want to pack the structs together as tightly as possible. Again, this is non-standard and potentially non-portable, and generally it's not a great idea. But again, for the purposes of this course, because we want to make sure that everything is read in and stored in the struct in the same manner that it's stored on disk, we're going to use this in a couple places in this course.